Дирижерские уроки профессора Мусина.
Conducting lessons of Professor Илья Мусин. A necessary warning.
Впервые в истории дирижерской педагогики появилось.
It's only now that we have such a wonderful teaching facility as video records.
Должен сказать, что в моем классе несколько таких.
There are several TV cameras rolling on in the classroom at the moment. The art of conducting is the most visual of all types of musical performance.
Должен сказать, что результаты того, что.
And I must admit, the results of my students' shooting lessons are impressive. To see once is better than to hear a dozen times.
Но вот это же свойство. Видеокамеры, оно
however useful, a video recording has got to be put to the right use. Nota bene. Thoughtless copying leads nowhere. It's impossible to teach conducting to someone as much as to learn it without forming for yourself a well-grounded view on this art. What's the art of conducting, then? I'll start with a funny story. A young student comes to an accomplished maestro and asks to teach him the art. The other one agrees and gives him a lesson. You give two beats like this, for three beats like that, this is for four beats, etc. A larger gesture calls for forte, he goes on to explain, a smaller for piano. That's it. Is that all? The young man asks, rather shocked. I'm afraid yes, just that simple. But you don't tell this to anybody, okay? Conducting is a very simple thing. A contrasting opinion we find in a famous saying by Richard Strauss, who declared, everybody knows conducting is difficult, but you have to live to the age of 70 to realize what a challenge it is. So, conducting is difficult, and very much so. Where does the truth lie then? Ask a violin player who is not trained to play piano, to perform a Beethoven sonata or a concert by Tchaikovsky. We can also tell him how to do this, but will he manage? No. The same with a pianist told to perform a violin piece. Similarly, he won't be able to copy the example shown. However, if a musician is shown, like in that story of mine, how to give beats in this or that time, after a fortnight's practice, He will not hesitate to take up conducting symphonies by Mahler, Bruckner, or even Brahms. Beating time is simple. We have examples of conductors who can do their job skillfully enough. However, you'll find no expression in their performance. It will be that formal beating time that inspires neither the players nor the hearers. It's difficult to direct music. In the hands of other conductors, a music piece becomes something live and tangible. The hearer finds a unique pleasure in witnessing how music is being created before his eyes. Thus, we can say there are conductors who are only able to beat the time and set tempo. Ergo, not everyone who is able to conduct can be called a true conductor. Charlie Munsch. And there are those who really animate music, make it vivid and full of meaning. To convey a musical image, its meaning, is the main task of the conductor. He must learn to do this. However, on the general, conductors are taught to copy their teacher's example. It leads to their eventually becoming sort of road police officers, who regulate traffic flows at a crossroads. They show nothing more than the direction for cars to go. They aren't involved in the performance of music. Alpha and omega of conducting is to reveal musical images. It's essential for both the performance of the orchestra and the perception of audiences. Copying some other's gestures is very easy. To develop one's own style of conducting is incomparably more difficult. For this, one has to have talents that may be cultivated. They also can be ruined in a student by improper teaching. It depends on a student's intentions and his attitude towards the art. I know of young, gifted conductors who have never developed beyond the skill of beating time, because their teachers taught them nothing else and didn't give them a motivation and aim for development. They were not aimed at the right purpose, and vice versa. A musician, inspired by greater examples, begins to perform more expressively. He leads the orchestra, sometimes without proper musicianship. He has somehow got the gist of the art, which enables him to grow and improve freely. Now let's examine which particular qualities a true conductor must possess. What is a gift for conducting? What is the right attitude towards conducting? Till the present day, the enrollment for conducting courses in conservatories is a mere audition. An applicant comes along and conducts before the committee, but this proves nothing. If he performs well, it may have resulted from his talents, as well as from simply having been well coached for the exam. Suppose his performance is poor. That's very likely to be due to bad teaching. When this first test is over, a decision is made on such a shaky basis. Then the applicant's ear for music is put to test. A dozen of modulation chords are played with the task of reproducing them. It may happen that an able student who has passed the conducting test successfully can't do it and is therefore rejected. Is that the right decision? Absolutely no. A good ear for music is no doubt essential, but it's not the only gift a true conductor must possess. Which qualities is a conductor expected to have? It's not enough for him to be a good performing musician, violinist or cellist. He must be a man of great learning and culture, able to discern the structure of a piece of music, its composition. First, a student conductor, as a performing artist, must possess certain personal qualities. He has to possess a sense of music and the ability to express it in his gestures. Second, he has got to have a powerful imagination that would make it possible for him to put himself in the composer's place and experience the actual creation of a particular music work. Only then his ideas about the piece will be convincing to the players and the hearers. Thus, he will be a true leader of the orchestra. Third, however, this is not enough. A person may be gifted well enough, but his, her conducting is inconvenient for the orchestra that gives a poor performance in the end. It's the fate of amateurs. The concept of the art of conducting implies that a conductor's active, creative attitude towards a piece of music brings it back to life from the dead written score, brightens up every phrase. On the other hand, he's got to be able to convey his ideas by means of gesture to make the players understand what he wants. To animate a music phrase, a conductor must be a true master of agogics. His control of dynamics has to employ all possible means beyond simple cues for piano and forte. There is no suggestion in the score how to make music sound meaningful and animated. It's not explained in the orchestral parts, but he must make everything clear to the players. Nota bene, a conductor must develop his technique to the degree of perfection. The technique is based on muscular sensation that has to be developed first of all. What makes a good performing musician? A distinct feeling of his hand movements that corresponds to his musical ideas.
И движением рук. Вот это то, что создает исполнителя.
Вот the same is required of a conductor.
Но только разница в том, что пианист развивает
a piano player needs his fingering to be brisk and precise, his knowledge of the keyboard perfect and close to automatism. A violinist tries to develop the faultless sense of distances on the fingerboard and the sense of his bowing movements. Likewise, the conductor must learn to express his intentions by means of gesture. This knowledge can be only acquired through a comprehensive study and self-study, through unceasing pursuit of perfection. Teaching methods of the do-like-me kind generally are of no help in achieving the goal. Punctum saliens. A conductor must learn to express his ideas by means of gesture. Gestures are the language of a conductor.
Дирижер имеет в основе
From the beginning,
своей техники,
как you must learn that giving beats is the basis of conducting.
Без
Like a building that stands on its foundation, a conductor's communication with the orchestra is based on this skill. Giving beats is the foundation of conducting technique. When a conductor, however, in search of a more genuine expression, wants to show relations between notes within a phrase, he will have to alter the rhythmic pattern of a bar. To show culmination, rhythm, and most important, the mood of the music. This is when and how a meaningful gesture is born. It often so happens that someone has no education. However, he had a chance to work with the orchestra and learn some of the practical skills. He does his best, but in an awkward manner. Therefore, the orchestra have difficulties in keeping to rhythm. Warning. Dilettantism.
Задача заключается
A conductor's task
чтобы делать
выразительные is to present his gestures in such a way that musical expression in them does not conflict with the rhythmical pattern of beats within a bar.
Изменяя в то же время их свойства. Вот это то, что должен по-настоящему...
That is what conducting students must be taught first of all.
Что он должен развивать у студента.
The art of conducting lies in overcoming the conflict between giving beats and genuine expression.
Это наличие противоречий между
закономерностями тактирования и закономерностями conducting on the one hand.
То есть нужно, чтобы движение
often comes into contradiction with the strict concepts of time, rhythm and tempo on the other.
Метра, ритма, темпа исполнения. А для этого
However, this cannot be resolved at the expense of any of them. The one thing depends on the other. To achieve this, one has, first, to know the conflict, and second, as a popular Russian saying goes, to check harmony by algebra. In conclusion, With this, I would like to end my introduction. The main thing I wanted here was to warn the students who may use this video course against simply copying the examples given. It may only hinder your personal development. The important goal you have to achieve is a keen individual sense of the right gesture in the right place. That is your main purpose. And getting the gist is better than copying a dozen times without comprehension. Beating time.
Итак, вернемся к тактированию.
Let us start from beating the time of music. First of all, beating time is a way for conductor to ensure rhythmically exact direction. Second, it is a method of self-control. You should remember, beating time must be absolutely precise. The neglect of this principle results in several negative things. First, a conductor's gestures lose the rhythm. Second, a conductor does not feel at ease to alter freely the plan of giving beats in a bar in pursuit of a better expression. Pro memoria. Beating time is the backbone of the art of conducting. Conducting technique is the basis of beating time. Downstroke is the foundation of conducting technique. The downstroke must be sharp and precise. Its proper performance is absolutely essential. Many things depend on this. Vida. Look, I will show you how to do it. You can do it with this position of the hand, another position. The last time, the click was more exact. Remember that you should not jerk the hand back. Its fall and rise must be equally fast and equally big motions. It's necessary to feel how your hand falls down freely and then makes the click. Repeat. Repetator. In one word, it is the keystone of conducting technique. Mastering this sort of stroke is not that difficult. I often meet student conductors whose hands seem to be crippled and are incapable of doing anything the right way. All I can do is to teach them again from the beginning. What's the problem in most cases? It's very simple. They can't make two motions by their hands in the same way, two motions that are similar in the way they are executed. Still more important is that they don't have the same feeling that corresponds to the gestures. Exercise. The gesture is to be made as a bow-shaped hand movement. At first, the curve is small, then it gradually grows bigger. Most important is to make sure that the downstroke remains. Repeat. Repeat. Mistake. The slip here occurs due to the shifting the hand to the right. Hence, the click is being done sideward, not downward. The stroke is rather blurred. You should remember that in whichever direction your hand is moving, the stroke must always be made downwards and never aside. It must be a real click, not an uncertain sort of motion. First, we'll make two strokes. Then we can practice three strokes. And eventually, all this easily turns into beating time. One, two, three, four. You can see that we are making the fourth downstroke a bit higher. One, two, three. Then clicks for the first and the third beats. Repetatur. Mistake. Beats of a bar are normally given by one hand. The line of its movement should start right from the shoulder. The first stroke must fall down there and not aside. Teachers often ask their students to give beats in this way. One, two, three, four. It's unnatural. Only this manner is right. One, two, three, four, down here. Or like this. One, two, three. One, two. Try to find the mistake. You can see 1, 2, 3, 4 that the fourth beat is given in some special way. 1, 2, 3, 4. The principle of equality of hand motion is not followed here. The last time is given with a sort of jerking the hand back, rather than by a proper click. One, two, three, four. First, this gesture is faster than the other ones. Second, it does not prepare the next first beat. One, two, three, four. I have brought the hand to where the first beat starts, whereas in this case, one, two, three, the upbeat looks rather vague and uncertain. This blunder often occurs when a conductor student learns to beat time. Respice finem. Mistakes in the beginning give poor results in the end. All I'm explaining now, I've taken from my teaching experience. I have more than once had to deal with such problems while teaching those elementary things to students. Pro and contra. Some teachers instruct their students to set the elbow aside while conducting. One, two, three, four. This is unnatural, because the downstroke does not have a foothold. One, two, three. To have it, both the arm and the elbow should be in the same line. Others teach to press the elbow to one side. One, two, three, four. Some also think that for a piano sound, this gesture is needed. Others yet advise to put the hands forward. All those distortions give poor results. Teaching the same again is always harder than teaching right things from the beginning. A most common mistake is when students try to beat the time with both their hands, when the left hand simply copies the movements of the right one. You should remember that to learn to beat time rightly is essential for a good conducting technique. Nota bene. Beating time must be precise. Only when mastery of beating time is achieved can a conductor freely alter the plan of beats to a bar. You have to vary the scheme of beats to find a more expressive gesture. It does not mean all beats you give should be alike. More important still is the task of showing the function relations of beats to make clear the musical structure of a phrase, to indicate its culmination, and eventually to bring out the musical image as is conceived by the conductor. All this can be only shown by means of changing the plan of beats in a bar. Example. Stop. I won't tell anything. I'd better show. Play it once again, please. Is that clear? I have shown how drastically may this plan of beats in a bar be changed. All beats are given by downstrokes. There are cases, however, when all beats are to be shown by upstrokes. Ergo. First of all, you have to learn to beat time. Beethoven, sonatas. I have chosen several short examples of music that will show you clearly how the conducting technique works. I strongly recommend using these examples. The music is well known. These examples are very illustrative, concise, and can be wonderful technical drills for beginner conductors. Staccato, Sonata 10, second movement. This is an exercise for practicing a staccato gesture. You see that only the hand is working, not the whole arm. The click is also made solely by the hand. I hope you have got it. Some of the clicks are being slightly accented. We will have time to talk about it later. Besides that, I guess you have noticed that in the middle of the exercise there is a passage requiring legato. That will be our next drill. But before, let us practice staccato once again. This is a very useful drill if practiced regularly with variations of rhythm and dynamics. Repetatur. This is a very useful drill if practiced regularly with variations of rhythm and dynamics. Legato, Sonata 8, second movement. What is important here? It's important that there is no return of the hand after a click. Do you remember this return of hand in the first example? The hand moves smoothly from one beat to another. Thus, the connection of beats is emphasized. This also makes for it that the conductor feels he really directs the music of the bar, not only gives the beats of it. He builds the whole musical phrase of single notes. You know that a musical phrase is not simply a sum of notes. It's an absolutely new concept. Breathtaking. Showing the breath within a musical phrase is essential. You should remember that music could not go properly without such breathtaking. Now that you know a lot more already, you will in greater detail perceive what I show you. Look, I lead the music to the third beat. Then on to the next bar. To the third bar, and at last, to the conclusion. Let us dwell on a rather important gesture called here. It literally indicates some point in the space. The here gesture. We frequently use this gesture in our everyday life. We ask a person, take a seat here, please. Or, pass me that book, please. Each musical phrase has its development and culmination. To indicate the culmination, a conductor can use exactly this sort of gesture. In our example, I'll use it in the second bar. Look. There is another interesting thing about this phrase. You could see that the music sort of came to a halt in the second bar. I mean, on the piano it was still being played, but the sound was not as intense as before. To show this, I conducted with the hand only, my arm being still. Take the breath. The inviting gesture. A breath. A breath. Here. You see now, how a simple melody becomes meaningful because I show its length or only the accompaniment, I indicate a breath within a phrase or the here gesture. Example. The apparently elementary gesture here plays a key role if you want to show where the whole musical phrase goes, to show its development. A conductor must always show where to the melody goes. Look. Here. I'll do this once again. Carry on. Here. This hand indicates the conclusion. Now, no. The first gesture was wrong. It should be like scooping water from a stream. Right. Take it and bring it here. Take it from below. You scoop some water and then bring it here. Well done. Conducting and beating time are two different things. But the former does not exist without the latter. A conductor's hand is his instrument. Mistake. I'll tell you what sort of mistake you have made. Your hand is too strained. Watch me. My hand is not stiff. There is no tension in it. However, I'm not doing anything special. I simply let it open naturally. Conducting with both hands. First of all, I would like to warn you against using both hands in conducting. There is nothing so dangerous to the expression of gestures as the sameness of movements. If your left hand, in its parallel motion, simply copies the right one, it can destroy everything. Here we have an interesting example. Take, for instance, a scene from the Swan Lake. Watching a corps de ballet dancing, we enjoy the exactness of steps, performed synchronously by all dancers. We'll use the adagio, where the heroes express their feelings. If, however, the soloists began doing the same thing, that would be stupid. This applies to conducting quite as well. Look, I'm working with one hand only, and it's all right. And now, it's a parody of conducting. Nevertheless, many seem to be unaware of this simple truth. Their gestures look more like physical exercise or gymnastics. It's not what one would call the true conducting. Mistake. Thank you. That's what I've been trying to warn you against. The two ways of conducting. Normally, a conductor works with one vacant hand or the baton. Yet, I would recommend beginner students of conducting to practice without the baton. The stick in itself has many advantages, but requires a certain amount of technical skill. It's very often that the baton in a conductor's hand looks like something unnecessary or even alien, like some sort of prosthetic appliance. Conducting without a baton. What does this method give? By not using the baton, a conductor activates the natural plasticity of his hand. The movements of the hand and the fingers do the actual shaping of the sound. With a stick, it would be much harder. For instance, a soft sound can be shown with a bare hand by far better. Secondly, a hand is capable of producing very exact clicks, particularly if positioned like this. You can fling your arm forward without fear that the hand will drop further. Such a beat, given in another way, would require stopping the hand artificially at the low part of the movement to stop it moving, or you might have this. In the following case, however, you can move your arm without running the risk of the hand dropping much lower than is required for the click. Besides that, a conductor may use his fingers. Their movements are very eloquent. The forearm deserves a closer consideration. By engaging the shoulder, a conductor can make his gestures larger. In some cases, the whole length of the arm can be put to work. The motion proceeds either horizontally or ahead from the shoulder. Most of conductors tend to use only one thing out of that selection, a movement of the whole arm. Neither his fingers nor his hand are used. Use your hand. What it means to conduct with your hand. Many years passed before I could realize this. The hand is not simply part of the arm. It's essentially the conductor's main tool. The hand possesses peculiar flexibility and sensitiveness that neither the arm nor the shoulder have. The moment you start working by the hand solely, it's all right. As long as you are conducting with the whole arm, your gestures look heavy and clumsy. Therefore, I want to emphasize it once again. Learn to use your hand. You should train your hand. Try to develop a sense of music in it. A hand click. I'm calling for a staccato sound with my whole arm. Look. Now the same thing with the hand only. Did it not look the first time like a TV set working with the sound switched off? Now I switch it on again. Again there is no sound. You can see now what a hand click means. You should always remember that even when you are conducting with the whole arm, the hand remains your chief instrument. The hand is a conductor's main instrument. The hand actually makes the click. The arm only helps it to move to the right place. Mistake. I often see conductors directing like this. Mistake. Another mistake occurs when this sort of gesture is made. As if we were telling someone, enough of this, go away. Nothing what concerns the music is expressed by it. This is the most expressionless position of the arm and the hand of all. Moreover, with the fingers spread wide like this, you can only produce an ugly impression. As though you want to scratch someone's face. I don't make all this up. Conductors do like this at concerts. You may hold your hand like this only when you are conducting with your arm in a low position. In all other cases, the hand should be positioned edgewise. Look. I'm conducting with my hand only. There is enough expression in the gesture, is it not? If then I do it this way, it looks as though I'm stroking something. This gesture in its turn conveys the idea of something elevated and lofty. In which other ways might this hand position be useful? We have already talked about it. To produce a proper click by a hand, one should fix its position at a certain point of its motion. Otherwise, the arm may come down to march and fail to make a stroke. I'd like to tell it again. You must fix the hand here. Now imagine that all this has to be done in a fast tempo. Has to stop the hand, then release it, then raise it, make a stroke, and stop it again. This is rather difficult to do and can make your gestures too heavy. With his hand in such a position, a conductor can give clicks without any caution. The hand will not go down beyond this limit. It simply can't do it. This is the point where the hand stops naturally. In this case, a strong impression of a click is created. A more forceful or less forceful click can't be made with a hand positioned as follows. Only this way will work. A naturally moving, flexible hand can solely produce an appropriate click. Fingers. Suppose you have to show a cantilena. It looks as if I'm picking the sound up with fingers. It's notable how I feel the music by fingers. With the little finger, the fourth one, the middle one. I actually have a feeling of something being led by me. Or else, as though I've scooped some water and bring it somewhere. Finger work is very important. The emotion must be clearly seen from your fingers. Fingers as such don't tell anything. If I do like this, however, you can see the gesture becomes meaningful. The same can't be conveyed by this gesture, or still another one, only this way. My fingers are intense and energetic. Though the gesture in itself corresponds to the music only by association. It's not rare that a conductor's gestures are associated with something in our everyday life. This gesture is used normally in an argument to assert something or for making demands. You can't demand with such a gesture. It's rather a polite request. A command requires a strong, assured movement of hand and fingers. One finger. You can make a meaningful gesture with one finger only. It happens sometimes that to show a melodic phrase, you don't need to use the whole hand or all of the fingers. You just bring your fingers closer to the palm, except the one that is actually working. Shoulder. That's interesting. Skydivers open their parachutes in order to stop their free fall. For a conductor, his shoulder plays the role of such a parachute. To slow down music, you should bring your shoulder into action. Look at me. You could see how simple it was for me to make a retard with the help of my shoulder. Now you have a go. Mistake. It so happens that a conductor directs with a baton for some time. Then he resumes conducting with a bare hand. What do we have in this case? He makes a fist, as though he still holds the stick. Thus, it's no longer the arm or hand that he makes his gestures with, but the fist. A fist in conducting, however, is close to useless. The left hand. When the left hand is unnecessary. We must admit that the left hand is more often a problem than help. It can sometimes work quite intensively, but seldom fruitfully. Why? Look. I give the same gesture with both hands. And what? My left hand, moving parallel to the right one, is of no support, but is a real killer of the gesture. As a result, the whole message to the orchestra is lost. It's a mere beating time. Beating time with both your hands is a double blunder. First, one poster is put up on the wall somewhere, then another copy of it is displayed aside. Who is going to read it, this second copy? Whereas everybody has to look at the hands of the conductor. How can the left hand be such an obstacle? While beating time is in the right hand, the left one is being idle or doing no matter what. Its movements are irrelevant and make no music. However, when the conductor needs to show something special, for instance, this, you can see what it looks like then. I'm conducting, and then just do this. Stupid, isn't it? So, there is no necessity for making the same gestures with both hands. Ironically, it seems that the left hand becomes a hindrance when it sort of wants to be in the show. When, however, the conductor stops it from working, the right hand gets affected by this control too. In fact, we can make our left hand be really helpful. It may be used to supplement the message of the right hand or make some valuable comments. What the left hand is capable of. I make a simple gesture by my right hand. Its meaning is not perfectly clear yet. Now look what I will do now. It's the same motion, but a slight tension in the left hand adds something to its nature. Your left hand can also show a piano sound. Or, conversely, it may call for crescendo. To put it short, the left hand is a useful addition to the work of the right one, something that helps a better apprehension. One of its advantages is freedom not to be engaged in beating time. It can be therefore used for any other purpose. It can be introduced at any place, at the bottom, at the top, anywhere. It can work in any position. Example. This scene of tender love used to be called by the composer the Prince and the Princess. Your dry and unemotional conducting is completely out of place. Look. Don't forget the basses. Mistake. It's all lost, because I'm conducting in parallel motions with both hands. This time, only one of them will be used. something is missing. What do you think? My main goal is to draw a picture of the prince burning with love. You have to use your imagination. Repetatur. Why is the left hand so helpless? This is the outcome of conductors not working hard enough on their hand technique. Look, I can do anything. 1, 2, 3, 4. With this hand, I am giving 4 beats, while with the other one, 3 beats at the same time. It goes quite mechanically. And both my hands obey the master. I've heard of a conductor whose right hand stopped when he had to turn over the pages of the score by the left one. This simple gesture, compatible with another one, 1, 2, 3, 4,
what?
You can make yourself look very silly in that way. That is why a conductor must work more on his left hand. That is the only way to make it work independently and equally well. Exercises for the left arm. This one is very simple. You can do it in various times. Make roundish sort of movements in this direction, and then back again. This is a drill for your hand. Try to make 8 shaped motions. At the very same moment, the other hand should be doing something else. Now bring the 8 shapes to the horizontal plane. In one word, you can develop your left hand by trying to engage it in some way while the right one is conducting. Postulata unus. Generally, it's not only the hands that actually do the conducting. It's the entire body and its movements.
Поэтому изолировать движение руки от его существа нельзя.
After all, you can't speak of hands as the conductor's tool without minding the position of the body, or the feet, or his mimics too.
Каково его положение корпуса и так далее. Это очень важно.
One side of it all helps and makes clearer the other. And in this respect, a proper use of your left hand is very important for the expression of musical images.
Дает левая рука.
In fine, make your left hand help the right one. Conducting with the baton. Mistake. Well, what can I say to this? You've been conducting with a lot of emotion, but your hand was too strained. I say, this music should sound as though it has been cast in glittering metal. You have presented it all in a dull, expressionless sort of way. Generally, music such as this symphony's finale should be conducted with the baton. The stick makes the gesture sharp and springy. Your overstrained hand looks like an awkward heavy paw that burdens the music. The baton. What does it mean to conduct with the baton? It often happens that the baton, instead of being a natural extension of the arm, becomes a sort of artificial limb. As to any prosthetic appliance, one has to get used to it. How should you hold it? There are three ways of holding the stick. Position 1. The stick should be grasped in such a way that its end is set against the center of the palm. Don't press it with all your fingers, however. Take it with the thumb, the forefinger, and the middle finger only.
Можно так раз, два, три, четыре, но ограничено.
This helps a conductor to give a good, exact beat without tension in the hand. The gesture becomes expressive and clear. With the baton thus positioned, you can show legato as well. This is the most simple and most common position of the baton in the hand. With it, you can conveniently start learning the rest of the technique. Position 2. This one already requires some skill. The baton must not touch the palm. Hold it with the three fingers. All of the baton's movements are controlled by fingers only. For a forte sound, you should not give the click with all your hand, as we did without the baton. This gesture would look like whipping. Besides this, the baton will start vibrating. The forte you are calling for might not be the result, after all. Look, to make the downstroke, you've got to put your hand forward.
Pam, 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 pam.
This position of the baton is universal. With it, you can show a solo fragment or call for an airy piano sound or else for forte. In addition, it makes your hand longer and adds scope and expression to gestures. I think this position may be called the basic one. Position 3. The third position of the baton in your hand is achieved by a slight turn of it. It seems to be a microscopic difference. In fact, however, this change of position brings out many expressive potentialities of a gesture. You can use it when the lightest, most airy musical images are to be created. That's because I'm working with my fingers alone. You should not conduct like this. Although this is wrong. You must move your hand only. Due to the use of the stick, the palm becomes longer and is clearly seen. Look, the position of the stick in a conductor's hand may greatly influence his performance. However, as it often happens, the same position of the baton can show different, sometimes opposing things. Importance of rightly positioning the baton. Take, for instance, the last part of the overture of Egmont or Leonore. There is a solemn passage with trumpets there. I'll direct it like this. Nothing majestic in it, is it? To make it sound solemn, I have to raise the hand quite high. Now I have done so, and what? As though I'm urging someone to leave, go, go, or driving him away. It means such position of the stick in the hand gives nothing. I'm going to change it. I feel very uncomfortable now. Another sort of grip. Quite another matter now. Now I look like a commander who leads his regiment into a battle with a saber raised high. I'm working with the hand and fingers only. If you compare once more, you will see that this was a heavy, awkward gesture, causing the music to be burdensome too. Conductor has to love his stick. You should love the baton and handle it with care. To learn to be master of the stick, you must not let it out of your hands at the beginning. You should practice day and night. Remember that all intentions of the conductor, born in his head and soul, must be felt in his hand and gesture. It's the hand that communicates his ideas to the orchestra. Mistake. Sorry, but your conducting tells nothing due to a wrong position of the baton. The movements of your baton are viscous and unclear. Hold it like this. Now you needn't think about your hand. It will not go beyond this point. Example. Piano. Move the hand. Now bring the stick up. Try to work more with the end of the stick. Bring it up. Work with your hand. Move it. well done. Well done. Mistake. No, that is wrong. The theme of the princess should be directed by the hand only. Look, all airy melodies generally have to be directed with the hand. Staccato is also shown with fingers slightly holding the stick here. I'm not pressing the stick. I'm doing it with my fingers solely. Look. I've got the whole of the music in my hand. Mistake. The hand must be moving from below upwards. Three movements up and one downstroke. Look, I told you once that the stick isn't an artificial limb. You must grasp it so that the musical image is shown in the most convincing way. To slice a loaf of bread, you have to hold a knife like this. To thrust the knife, you would take it another way. Your conductor's stick is a far more important instrument. Remember that your gesture must correspond to the sound you want to hear. This hand motion does mean nothing. Whereas that one is closer to the music. In this musical passage, I discern a grotesque picture of a jester, Il Pagliaccio. I'll try to find a gesture that would be adequate to this image. Here I use the delayed type of upbeat. Set the baton edgewise. Edgewise. Play with the stick. Stop, please. No, that is wrong. Vide. I would like to tell you once again. Look, I'm conducting now, like she just did. My gestures tell very little. They only say, just go on playing. Now look how I'll do it this time. I'm playing with the stick. I'm showing that some new image is introduced here. In fine, you have to develop your muscles as though you were a juggler. However, the juggler works with balls, while you juggle with your hands. Abbit.
Auftakt. Это та, что ли?
Abbit, or in German Auftakt, is a basic unit of measure for the conductor to indicate the rhythm and tempo with. Yes, it's a unit of measure.
Это счетная единица. Она может состоять.
It may last a quarter note, two quarter notes, or even an eighth note. Abbit is a gesture. It prepares every beat of a bar. Its length is equal to that of the beat that is being prepared. A plan of giving beats in a bar is a chain of such abbits. How should an abbit be given? Or better still, what a preparation abbit has to tell the orchestra? Basic function. First of all, an abbit indicates the moment for all players to start. This is its main goal. Without a proper performance of an abbit, the conductor can't ensure an accurate ensemble. Supplementary function 1.
Во-вторых, дирижер.
Abbit is also used to set the tempo by giving it at the desired rate. Supplementary function 2. By giving an abbit, a conductor shows the dynamics of music he wants to hear. Be careful with the common notion that large movements call for forte. Nothing of the kind. A large gesture can show piano quite as well. Look, I'm making a rather large gesture now, but it doesn't mean forte. Forte is essentially some sort of tension in sound, its intensity. To show this intensity, the conductor must first of all have a feeling of it in his soul and muscles. For a forte sound, the conductor should find a hand motion that is rich in energy, not only big in size. Supplementary function 3. Then, by giving an abbit, a conductor shows what sort of sound it should be, flowing or sharp. He begins it with a smooth or jerky gesture, respectively. Most important. The conductor must pursue his main goal, to convey a musical image in his gestures. It's particularly important in works that begin in fermata, that is a long first beat. Good examples are Coriolan on Die Zauberflöte. It's all different music with different meaning. From the beginning, by an abbit, you should make it perfectly clear to the orchestra. By way of exercise, I often ask my students to try to show by a mere abbit the tempo, the dynamics, and most important, the nature of the music they are going to perform. The latter may be solemnity, liveliness, or even something playful. Example. Take, for instance, the beginning of Die Meistersinger. It starts solemnly. I'm not doing anything special. Now I wish to show the beginning of a stormy tune. Absolutely different gesture. The main types of abit. Professor Musin's terminology. Initial, preliminary abit. Full abit, for a full note value beat. Half abit, for a reduced note value beat. Within the bar abit, in between beat abit. Full abit, for a full note value beat. Half abit, for a reduced note value beat. This is an abit preparing a full value fourth note. Here I'm giving the abit as an anacrusis. It leads to a reduced value fourth note. This abit is different in the way that I'm making a smaller hand swing, not forgetting to indicate the beginning point, however. Initial abit for a full note value beat. Full abit. The communication of the conductor with the orchestra begins when he's only raising his hand to give the abit. The abit in itself must already contain all hints and cues to the players on how he wants the music to go. It's clear that tempo is indicated by the speed of the hand movements. How can the dynamics of the music be shown then? You would think through mere making the gesture wider. Not that simple. More important is the conductor's inner stimulus, his feeling of the music. Mistake. Even for forte, you have to make a smaller movement, showing your intentions by the intensity of the gesture, its throb, rather than size. Only the highest point, the culmination, should be indicated by a wider hand wave. Look! Example. Now let us think of a conductor who has come out to his stand and raised his hand. The audience has not settled down yet, and so he is standing with his hand raised. What is his next step? There it is. As soon as the hearers are ready, he just indicates the start. For the orchestra, the abit is all of a sudden, however. To indicate the starting point of the whole motion, the conductor must give a preliminary warning gesture. Now, let them make themselves comfortable, cough, all sorts of things. The conductor can wait a long time, 5 minutes, more, and then he gives the abit. Now the players know when to come in. A small warning gesture is not sufficient for an accurate start either. A warning upward motion is what makes the orchestra take a breath. There should always be a warning hand movement. What adds even more significance to it is that the conductor can actually take a breath himself. When he does so, it's a hint for the wind players to take a breath for the start. In the way I will show it now, they just don't have time to. Hand motions must be equal. I have raised my hand. It's all right. The orchestra have started. Now I will do it another way. And nobody sees what I mean. They're all waiting for the hand to move to this place, while I have made a motion to there. Everybody in the orchestra is puzzled, because they have been expecting a full upbeat. Ergo, hand motions must be equal in size, in amplitude. Initial upbeat for a reduced first beat, half upbeat. A half upbeat is given when the beat opens with a pause, lasting for an eighth note, maybe longer or shorter. Which means that the anachronism counts one or two sixteenth notes, or an eighth note, or even some three notes altogether. Only one length at the beginning is missing. What should a conductor do in this case? There should be no take the breath signals. The upbeat gesture must begin exactly in its starting point. But some sort of warning hand motion before the upbeat is necessary anyway. That means I want it to be done like this. That way it will not work. Example. This is the beginning of Beethoven's Fifth Symphony, quite a challenge for a conductor. The anachronism counts three eighth notes. The first eighth note is missing. Hence, no upbeat may be used. We have to give a jerky start here. Some teachers and many established conductors consider it the best way to start in this case. But I believe it's not the most convenient one. Imagine a conductor coming to his stand, raising his hand, with the audience still unsettled, and then, all of a sudden, putting things in motion. The orchestra is simply not ready, because a warning gesture must have been given. It's even more important to make a preparing movement before the upbeat, if it's executed in 3/8 or else in 3/16, which is not the upbeat proper, but sort of preliminary signal that warns of the forthcoming upbeat. We can find examples of this in the Fifth Symphony by Beethoven and in Strauss' Don Giovanni. Repeat it, please. Full initial upbeat. Half initial upbeat. Having prepared the first beat of a bar, the initial upbeat, so to speak, resigns its commission to the so-called within-the-bar or in-between-beat upbeat. Within-the-bar upbeat, in-between-beat upbeat. Like initial upbeat, this type consists of three motions made by the conductor's hand. Upward motion, downward motion, and a bounce or kick, like after a gunshot, that follows the stop of the hand in the lowest point. In within-the-bar upbeats, the rise of the hand and the bounce are naturally merged into one movement. Look, one, to, on the one hand, the same hand motion is a kick after the first beat. On the other, it's an upbeat preparing the second beat of the bar. Raise the hand and drop it. This is the upbeat for the second beat. Or else, you can do it like this. Repeat. Mistake. Remember that within the bar rabbit not only prepares the next beat of the bar, but also tells a lot about the beat that is still going on. A common mistake is that a conductor is already thinking ahead to prepare the next beat. Thus, he forgets to take care of his upbeat gesture while the music of the previous beat is still being played. These motions are often executed in a hasty, rhythmless sort of way that can leave a false impression and spoil the smooth flow of the music. While on the contrary, this gesture must convey the idea of a rich, continuous sound. So a conductor must bear in mind that with this only gesture, one, two, he gives the first beat, and at the same time prepares the next one as the continuation of the whole phrase. One, two, three. If I do like this, it's simply beating the time, telling the players nothing. What follows from that? The motion that connects beats within a bar is one of the chief means of communicating the conductor's intentions to the orchestra. It shouldn't be a mere flick, as many proclaim, but a connecting hand wave. The first necessity for it is to be done according to a rhythmic plan. There are two basic ways of rhythmical subdivision of a beat, a duplet and a triplet. A duplet gesture. Preparation for a duplet beat. A duplet gesture occurs when a hand motion is split into two stages. Look. One and two and three and four. A triplet gesture. Preparation for a triplet beat. A triplet gesture is a smooth, unbroken motion of hand in which, however, three separate sounds of the beat should be clearly perceptible. I'll show it now. One, two, three. One, two, three. Or else another manner.
Раз, два, пам, 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 пам. Теперь ра-та-та-та-та-та-та-та-та-та-та-та.
Example. Look.
А вот глядите. Пожалуйста, играйте.
Play, please.
Я просто спасибо.
I have just sort of pushed the beat off, letting it to go on without my guidance as to its message. It's like a nice hockey, when you jab the puck, and then it just flies off. It's not right. You should direct the beat and not abandon it. It's especially important when a duplet, as in this example, is immediately followed by a triplet. Play, please. You see how this note is singing. You did it in quite another way. A conductor's live boy. Now we will talk about a particular sort of gesture, conventionally called a loop. This is very important. It often occurs that duple rhythm in melody is counterpointed by triple rhythm in accompaniment. It's frequently found in Tchaikovsky's works. A conductor starts to direct the melody, while the French horns are playing triplets. As a result, the conductor is confusing them. If, however, a loop is used, the gesture will be perceived as corresponding to both the duplet and the triplet. This motion is comparable to a live buoy on a ship. When a problem arises, it can save the conductor. A connecting gesture. Again, I should say that within the bar beat is a gesture that connects beats of a bar. It's the main means of communicating the conductor's ideas about the music to the orchestra. It's the conductor's intentions that determine the way of execution of the gesture. Rather important is that it should fill the beat and don't distort the rhythmic pattern of the bar. At the same time, showing to the players how the music has to be shaped. Breathtaking. The breathtaking in within the bar rabbit should be shown as follows. There must be no bounce after the flick. Only the initial upward motion of your hand remains. Look, 1, 2, 3. My hand stopped before the third beat. 1, 2, 3. Now I have lifted it. So that the gesture means not the continuance of the third beat, but an abit for the fourth one. Look, 1, 2, 3. So, first, second, take the breath now. The hand stops at any point of the beat, but only stops. You see how I am doing it? No, this is wrong. The hand stops, and I indicate the breath taking with it. That is how breath taking is shown when a continuous melody is being played. Mistake. Your main mistake is that you only give accents without forming a complete, meaningful phrase. Watch me closely.
Пожалуйста, глядите.
Now look at this. I'm trying to show that the phrase has been built toward this point. No. Imagine you've got to put something on the upper shelf in a cupboard. Put it again. And you've been just giving time without expression. Functional relations of beats. Upbeats for staccato and legato are different. When staccato is required, a conductor has to show the accentuation with strong, distinct flicks. A continuous melody, cantilena, needs a smooth, even motion that shows functional relations of beats. I'd like to point out to you once again, you have to show functional relations of beats in a bar. That is how the phrase goes to its culmination. For instance, in the score you find a staccato expression mark, but the actual gesture has to leave an impression of legato. Watch now. I'm indicating the functional building of the phrase, not the required staccato. Here, the most important task is to show a melodic phrase. To do it properly, the hand motion needs to be continuous, a loop-like gesture. I'm showing legato now. 1, 2, 3, 4. The first beat is given with the hand returning to starting point. But there is no functional relation with the second beat. If, however, I do it like this, hence, the first beat should not be shown with a simple return from below upwards, but with a circular movement of the hand. It's like a tramway that reaches the dead end of rails and can only go backwards. While if there is a circular road, it can easily turn round. The same applies to your gestures. They shouldn't merely flap downwards, upwards, but make a loop instead. The loop is very useful when cantabile is to be shown. Split beats. In a very slow time, the execution of the upbeat gesture gets a bit more difficult. While downbeat is being executed, players don't always see clearly when they should start playing. It's especially significant at the opening, when the tempo has not been set yet. That is the reason why in slow tempo conductors resort to subdivided beats. It means that each beat is shown twice. The upbeat becomes faster, which makes it easier for players to come in together. Repetatur. Mistake. You should remember the most common mistakes that are made in giving the upbeat for forte. Usually, conductors think that a more forceful and quick gesture is needed. They do it like this. As a result, The gesture sort of leaves behind the notes that are still being played at that moment. More than that, the conductor indicates crescendo and then waits for the music corresponding to the beat to be played. In fact, a beat for crescendo requires a gesture that gives an idea of seemingly lifting something heavy. If instead the conductor simply makes a large forceful movement with his hand, the emotional impulse of the gesture is soon exhausted, and it conveys nothing of the richness and dynamics that are wanted in the sound. Repetatur.
Idee auftakt. Bam. Bam.
Within the bar orbit for a reduced note value beat. Mistake. It's a very common error when a conductor does not focus duly on the last beat in the bar. He is already thinking ahead to prepare the first beat of the next bar. He is in a hurry to give the upbeat. The gesture is hasty. As a result, the last eighth or sixteenth note is jammed. Example. A very illustrative example, the unfinished symphony by Schubert, the second theme. Yes, the conductor gives a half upbeat, but the rate of it so high that the eighth note is smothered. Sorry, it's a sixteenth note. The eighth note goes next. They both are played hastily, and their length is reduced. You should remember, listening does not always mean hearing. A conductor must listen, hear, catch his own mistake and put it right. He may decide to make his gestures smoother, more flowing, or fill them with more meaning. But first of all, he must hear and realize how the music is going on. Beginner conductors often forget this simple rule. Repetatur.
Tira ra 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 ri ra ri ra ri ra tira ta ra la ri ra ra la ri ra 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 di ra.
Mistake. You forget that each phrase should have its focal point. Look. And you are doing it sort of in passing. Stop. stop this.
В оркестре, может быть, сыграют то, что у них написано.
You don't show the difference here. Yes, the quarter notes go first.
Были четверти, раз, там, пам, пам, пим,
but here you have eighths.
Та-там, та-та-там, пи-та-там. Вот эта восьмушка, она должна быть...
This eighth note should sound heroically, and you don't even notice it. Do it once again, please. No, sorry. You're not doing it right. I'll show you. This is a continuous accumulation of energy. Mistake. This is an interesting example. The mistake you are making here is glaring. Look at me. He gave only one beat in the bar. Then he decided to change to three beats. He showed the first time, and the players thought he went on giving one beat. To do it right, you have to change the amplitude of your gesture. One, two, one, one, two, three. One. One, two. Play, please. If you show it like this, there should be no problem. If you do it like this, however, the players will not understand you've changed the plan of beats in the bar. No, no, don't stop here. Go on right away to give the upbeat for the next first beat. Again, it's pointless to expect that the orchestra will understand you, because you are directing with this sort of gesture. You should remember this rule. While changing the number of beats from one to three in a bar, you should never give an upward directed upbeat immediately after the first beat. Look, one, two, three. I'll show again. One, one. One, two, three. It's clear. One, 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 two, three. Everybody in the orchestra will take this upward motion for the continuation of the first beat. Special types of upbeat. Rhythmical upbeat. Reversed upbeat. Delayed upbeat.
I
would like to talk now about matters that are more sophisticated. Until now, we have been learning to show how beats are related to each other within a bar by means of gesture. Now, we are to encroach on an exceedingly more complex territory, that of the interior of a single beat. Penetration into a single beat. Look. Play only chords without accompaniment, please.
Только одни аккорды. Видите?
The conducting seems to have been the same. In fact, it's different, because it doesn't show this 16th note. You'll see now how the note appears. It's there. This is the simplest case. It gets more complicated as it goes on. You remember, I hope, that each beat may be a duplet, that is, consisting of 2/8 or 4/16, or a triplet, counting 3/8 notes. This rhythmic pattern of a beat should be expressed by a conductor's gesture. Clearly expressed, I must say. Repetatur. This is a duplet gesture.
Papam, tatam, 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 tatam.
A triplet gesture. A triple beat should be given this way. Shall we go further? The problem is how to develop a sense of triple and duple motions in your muscles. Exercises will help you to achieve this. By my gesture, the concert master will play a duplet or a triplet. Now the piano player will play by my hand. It'll be either a duplet or a triplet. We have no agreement between us on what she has to do. It should be always clear from the conductor's gestures what he means. This is the basis of rhythmically correct conducting. This is our first insight into the inner rhythm of a beat. Show a duplet or a triplet. Please pay special attention to this. Note that the triple beat must be given in such a way that the third accent of it corresponds to the lowest point of the motion. For the first accent, the hand is moving upwards. The second accent is shown here, the third there. You must not wait. Look.
Я
You see, I'm waiting for the player to finish the triplet. That is the wrong way. Look, the third 16th note should be here. Many conductors neglect this fact, which often confuses the orchestra.
Игнорируется, просто не замечается. И они создают трудности в оркестре, потому что дирижер ждет, когда
If a conductor stops to wait until the orchestra have finished playing the first two beats before he can show the third one. It may puzzle the players, because they, in turn, are waiting for him to give the last accent of the triplet in the lowest point of his gesture. This is our first insight into the inner rhythm of a beat, and the most simple one. In fact, this rhythm is not always mere duplets and triplets. It is a far more complicated phenomenon. Rhythmical upbeat. What is a rhythmical upbeat?
Музыка становится медленной.
In a very slow tempo, it's normal to give 8 beats on a bar instead of 4 ones. 1 and 2 and 3 and 4. If, however, it's not yet that slow, but playing in 4 beats is already becoming difficult. The use of a rhythmical upbeat is recommended. That means I split the upbeat gesture into two parts. The second one of which is becoming, as it were, a half upbeat.
Не полным ауфтактом, ауфтактом не полной доли. Раз, па-пам, и та-там, та-там.
Вида.
Я сейчас вам продирижирую это для
Look.
Того, чтобы показать в сравнении.
I'm not using the rhythmical upbeat now.
Продирижирую без этого приема. Пожалуйста.
Consequently, my gestures give an idea of some hard work. The orchestra is also having trouble, because in this slow tempo, a 1/4 part of the beat, that is a 16th note, is very hard to discern. Dotted rhythm. This is a simple upbeat. Now look. Play, please.
Так, причем, глядите.
I can do it much slower.
Пожалуйста. даже в таком темпе. Теперь сравните это.
What if I do it with 8 beats in the bar, not using the device?
Пожалуйста. Видите, никакой торжественности.
You see for yourself, there is nothing characteristic about the gesture. It conveys no musical image. No feeling of solemnity. This rhythmical bounce of hand after the flick is particularly important for showing the so-called dotted rhythm. What else can be done with the help of this dotted rhythm motion, as I call it? I can show legato.
Legato, пожалуйста.
You see how the same rhythmic pattern is manifested in a legato gesture. Now I start with legato. And in the second bar, I'll show staccato for the basses by a more dry sort of motion, stopping the hand at flicks. Look.
Это какой-то там будет.
I can also do it like that. Example. There is another little thing to be remembered, a very small indeed, but as you know, small parts make up a car. Look. Start, please. Yes, it was better. What's the problem here? Look, first are coming fourth notes. And then you must have a feeling of this in your hand. Well done. A problem. A problem arises when piano sound is followed by 1/16th note of the beat, marked fortissimo. What conductors usually do in this case? They show forte for the whole beat.
Yes, вот сыграйте, пожалуйста. Тем-тарим. Потом.
Look. To indicate this 16th note, I gave a rather forceful first beat. thus misleading some of the instruments that are playing piano at that moment. That is a mistake. What is to be done here? That same rhythmical upbeat. It splits up the beat and allows a conductor to show a change of dynamics in the second part of it. Look. You see, the first beat is not intense. Only the second part of the beat is shown as forte. Once again. Here the phrase ends. Therefore, I don't make a heavy flick. Instead of this, the end of the phrase is being indicated. Once again. In one word, it enables me to show variations of the dynamics within a single beat. That is what the rhythmical upbeat means. A change of tempo within a bar. Would you start again, please? Thank you. Look what I'm doing. No, you didn't look at my hand. Once again, please.
Татим автор, татам, татам, татим, татам. Да, мне нужно второй случай.
Sorry, it was my fault.
Моя ошибка. Давайте. Второй, да, да. Да, да. И за так-то. Нет, нет, там тати ти та там та там да. Там.
Have you noticed the way I change the tempo? This device adds a lot to the conductor's power of shaping the music within a single bar. Regrettably, very few use it. A problem. A more complicated type of the dotted rhythm is a triplet. On the whole, a triplet is quite often played rather poorly. When executed to a dotted rhythm, it becomes still worse. Let's take a couple of bars from Scheherazade. Look what I'm doing. It's very often played like this. The 16th note comes in too late, and the 8th note is reduced. What should you do in this case? The beat is to be split into three parts. The second 8th note serves as an upbeat for the 16th note. Look. By splitting the beat, I can direct the music at any tempo without a change to 6 beats in a bar. This is essential when you have to deal with a dotted rhythm in a triplet. The difficulty it poses makes it sometimes very hard even to demonstrate. Can you play the beginning of the Fourth Symphony by Tchaikovsky? A rare example. It's a very unusual dotted rhythm. Normally, you would find the dotted rhythm in the first eighth note. We encounter a rare example of it in the Fourth Symphony by Tchaikovsky. A dotted pattern of rhythm is in the second eighth of the triplet. More than that, the last note is consequently a sixteenth in the Fourth Symphony by Tchaikovsky. An expressive sort of performance of this place is rare enough. The reason is that both the conductor and the orchestra do not conceive the gist of this rhythmic pattern. What should we do in this case? First of all, remember that a rest at the beginning of such a bar must be clearly indicated. I have rather exaggerated it. In fact, it looks like this. Compare this to what I'll do this time. Play the tune, please, without the rhythm. And now another way. As you can see, it's different. This is how this device has to be employed. Delayed upbeat. As a rule, the size or amplitude of a gesture corresponds to the volume of the sound. The larger the gesture, the louder the music. The amplitude, however, can't always convey the energy of the sound. There are other ways of doing it. There are many ways of showing an energetic gesture. One of them is the delayed upbeat, as I call it. What is a delayed upbeat? Raising and dropping the hand only requires me to put a certain amount of muscular force into it. Just to raise it and then bring down. As if I have to press a button. But then, all of a sudden, my hand already lifted. Some sort of thing or obstacle is inserted between the hand and the button, say a small slat. It prevents me from pressing the button. And I have to break the slat. And I do it. At this very moment, all energy accumulated in the hand bursts out in a downstroke. If I do it like this, no force can be felt. There are two types of a delayed upbeat. The regular and the reversed one. Regular delayed upbeat. Imagine that someone seizes my hand from behind at the highest point of the gesture. And I wrest the hand from the grip with all my strength. Now fancy how forceful the stroke will be. Look, I have accumulated all my energy in my gesture. The obstacle will be smashed. This device is to be used when you want to give a particularly vigorous upbeat. Reverse delayed upbeat. The term reverse delayed upbeat I apply to an upbeat gesture that is seemingly snatched not at the height of an upstroke, but immediately before reaching the flick at the bottom. It's more difficult to perform, but far more interesting and effective. Look what I'm doing. The upbeat I'm giving becomes a single swift motion of hand. I was stopped and then broke free. And the chord sounds full of vigor. What does this enable you to do? Forte sounds. If I show forte in this way, it's one thing. While by this, I call for a stronger, more powerful sound. Therefore, to bring out a greater, more intense or sharper sound, I have to give a reverse delayed upbeat. Soft sound. I make the upbeat gesture more swiftly. Delay the hand and call for sforzato. It may be quite as well shown when soft sound is needed. I could do the same thing in piano, too. Carry on, please. You see that intensity is clearly shown. Without increasing the volume of the sound. You have just to delay your hand and make a little movement with your fingers. And you have staccato. If I simply do like this, it's not explicit that I want staccato to be played. So I just do it, and nothing is unclear.
Pam, pam, tim, pam, pam, pam.
Controlling the tempo. Sometimes, when a conductor alters the scheme of beats in a bar, its rhythmic outline is distorted. It generally occurs when crescendo is to be indicated. The movement of the conductor's hand is quickened. For controlling the rhythm, a conductor can use a delayed upbeat.
Я дирижирую пам 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 пам. Вот я чуть быстрее провел руку.
I move the hand a bit quicker, but my sense of rhythm tells that the second beat is still ahead.
Вторая доля не наступила. Раз, пам. Я остановлю руку и подожду момента, когда будет вторая доля.
So I stop and wait for it. Pro memoria. This is a very important detail. A conductor must be the master of his hand. The hand will not control the time by itself. The rhythm is in the conductor's soul. It's transmitted to the muscles of the hand that actually make the stroke. The rhythm, however, originates in the head of the conductor. Unless it does, there will be no measure in the gesture. It happens more than often that expressive conducting alters the scheme of beats to a bar. In all cases of the loss of rhythm, a conductor can and ought to resort to the delayed upbeat. Reversed upbeat. I'll show it twice. Look at me. Now the same thing once again. Is that clear? First time, I just pushed off the first beat. Then I sort of took the sound and brought it somewhere ahead. It's like eating soup. You spoon up. And bring it carefully. Here. There. Here. Then I continue. That's the point all this has been coming to. Is that clear? I try not to dwell on the first two fourths, but go on further. And it's the reversed upbeat that helps me.
Еще, еще, это, и все. Нет, нет, нет.
What's a reversed abit?
Это значит, что ауфтакт выполняется как бы наоборот.
It's an abit that is executed the other way around, from the bottom up, as opposed to the normal downward movement. That's why it's conventionally labeled a reversed one.
Некоторые дирижеры чувствовали себя неловко из-за того, что оркестр играл.
Many great orchestras of the world play with some sort of minute lagging.
Дирижировал этим оркестром. Оказывается, оркестр филармонии.
You give the first beat, but they seem to be waiting for something. Then you make an upward gesture, and they start at last. It's this phase of the gesture where the actual beginning lies. There is always a simple solution. If a person tends to be 15 minutes late for every appointment, you just arrange the next meeting quarter of an hour later, and his delay will not count. In this case, the conductor should wait for the orchestra to come in at another place. Not here, but there.
И многие западные оркестры, там чикагские, бостонские,
it's all because the orchestra wants to see how the beat will go all together. Not merely the beginning point shown by the
abbot.
Look, I'm simply beating time. Watch the first beat. One, two, three, four. One, two. I show the beginning point and go on without taking the sound and drawing it as a line. Thus, nothing essential as to the conductor's intentions is being revealed. Now I will show it once again. Look.
Bam, 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 bam.
This time there is much more expression, because I actually draw the sound, not simply indicate the beginning and then withdraw the hand. This method of directing, in some respects, is more complicated, but incomparably more effective in attaining rich and clear expression. By this, an impression is created that the conductor goes a bit ahead of the orchestra. In fact, he only waits for the sound to start. Here. That's what I call a reversed
abit.
By means of it, I can show how the music of this particular beat should go. I make a gesture. It's a coherent, single motion, but there is no feeling of drawing the line of the sound by the hand. I don't feel I'm actually directing, leading the melody at that moment. Another feeling this reversed abit adds to the whole thing is that of almost physical sensation of the sound, of its weight and size. The conductor picks the sound up as something material and carries it. The sense of sound in a conductor's hand. Look, a student starts conducting. And I tell him, you have already finished. All your energy has been exhausted while giving the first beat. If you then want to take the sound and bring it somewhere, This point will only be the start of your journey.
Потому что взятие – это начало действия. Я взял, и теперь я
могу
поставить сразу на втором движении.
And can next put it somewhere.
Мое движение с тем, чтобы
or go on carrying it to some other place.
Что-то сюда. Либо перенести дальше еще.
Or even bring it further. Over here, for instance.
Вот. Короче говоря,
in short, a conductor may feel and therefore show to the orchestra the weight, size and intensity of the sound. And he feels this small gesture with a lot of meaning. I don't merely raise my hand, but do it with some force, thus pointing out to the players the strength and vigor of the sound, its intensity. Example. Well done and rightly enough, but that's not sufficient. Play the last two bars, please. It's not just some sort of picture. Once again. Do you see the difference now?
No.
That's no good. You have to do like me. That's very simple. Try to take more sound by your hand. See what I'm doing. One. Two. It starts from below. No. Take more sound. Have another go. You see now that, in fact, not much effort is necessary to do it properly. The sound is incomparably better. In fine.
И вот оказывается, что это обращенное в такт выразительное средство.
All this proves an abit to be a very effective means of musical expression. Though it should be admitted that in a fast tempo the successful use of it is more than arguable.
Почти невозможно. Там нужно пам 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 пам
I have reviewed only some of the aspects of a reversed abit. In fact, there are more of them. In each case, they manifest themselves differently. Their usefulness to a conductor in shaping the music should be remembered anyway. To be continued on disc 2.